Hello everybody, my name is Petr Koutoni and welcome back in another YouTube chess training video, and today I have a whole lesson from Max Euwe. Max Euwe was a Dutch chess grandmaster, and of course he was the fifth player to become world chess champion. And I have for you 9 examples how to improve your chess. I will try to show you how is great to have chess plan and how to find a chess plan. And we are in example number 1, so now it's your time and try to find a winning plan for white. So maybe stop this video for a few seconds, few minutes, I hope not for a few hours, and maybe come back with your answers. And I will tell you a secret. Every time when you are searching for a plan, ask where your opponent is weak. So in this position, looks like black is okay everywhere, but that's not the truth, because in this part of the chessboard, you can see there is waiting, you know, almost all black's army, but in this part of territory is only one defender, so looks like black should be weak on the right side of the chessboard, and it's our goal to find a plan how to play there, how to play and how to be aggressive on the right part of the chessboard. So the first move I will tell you is when white will take on a d6, and the different why this plan is so aggressive or so great you will see in next 2 moves. So white will take on d6, of course black will take, and we are going to take on f6, and check once again on the right part of the chessboard there is no defender, there is no army, and you know black is waiting for the last shot. Everything where black has his big power is on the left side waiting for nothing, and this is exactly the great plan to see, to understand. But don't worry if you miss this plan, never mind. What's important in this video, what's important in this lesson, to get new experience, to get a new feeling, and maybe you will get something close to your chess games, into your chess positions, and then you will be able to find nearly the same winning moves. So now you can see that if nothing happens, white will take another pawn, and this should be a big compensation. So maybe black should try to go to d7. What do you think? What should be the next white's move? And of course, now only one your plan is to go dead with all your pieces, go attack with all your pieces, and you need to use these 2 pieces. So the first move should be to go bishop to d5, because you are attacking on f7, you are looking to g8, and you wish to take on g6, because you know, if for example black is playing something stupid, we can take on g6, because there is check on f7, g8, so that's a big threat. And how black should save this pawn? Maybe he will go to h7, but thank you very much, game over. And you know, it's so great that from the first moves, you should win in next 4 moves in you have a good plan. Okay, maybe here black will play in this way, but that's the same. And the last move is rook to d3 and rook to e3 or f3, and of course white is winning. Different is that black is lost on the left side of the chessboard, because you know, you have to ask why black has this army here, what this army is doing here. Nothing, they are lost, and you know, this is a winning game. Beautiful example how to spot a weakness, how to spot a winning plan. And sometimes it's good to be active, sometimes it's good to be aggressive, and you should have experience. In this game black move it to f8, but of course another pawn, and you have to attack with all your army. That's different in this game, that's the lesson. You know, black was lost somewhere in nowhere. Now you have to add this bishop to game. But where do you think is the best square? Of course, that is so simple moves where you have the right plan. And now you need to add last shot. You need to find the last shot. You need to open black positions where black is weak. So if it's difficult to find better squares for your pieces, it's time to move with pawns. So move g4 is going to open, and if black is take, will take on g4, you are playing h5 and take on g6, and then should be a great checkmate on h6, and not so difficult. So we are playing g4. Of course, be very careful. I will show why we have to be careful in these positions where we are so close to the victory. Don't hurry and be careful, because maybe now you can ask why white should not take on f7, and I will show that if black will take on f7, we will take. Now one day we will be weak on f2, and you can see that check, and black should be the best player or better player in this game. So it's really important to be careful to check all our opponent's threats or moves or plans, and now play g4. And I love this position, because you know, this position looks like white is so close to the victory, but still he need to find one more move. And this is experience. This is exactly how we can learn our chess, to study great chess player of chess history and watch their games. And if we see move g4, I believe in our games we will play g4 without doubt. And now we are going to take on h5, check, and of course now white will take on f7. Maybe here you can see that black has more material, but the difference between activity is so huge that this position is not based on material. This position is based on the right plan and attack. So you know, I believe that this game is of course won, because nobody can doubt that black is lost, but we can watch this game till end. And that happens somewhere here. I hope that first example was nice and was a good start to the video. So maybe the recapitulation is to think where your opponent is weak, and I hope you will remember that if black has all army on the left side, it's a good idea to play in the right side, because there is something missing. And we are going to another example number two. In this position it's white on move, and what do you think what to play in this position where black is weak, or what's wrong with black? And maybe once again stop this video and think and try to find the best plan for white, because this is the best way how to improve your chess. In the meantime, thank you very much for follow in our YouTube chess channel. I hope you will press follow and you will not miss another video. So I'm back, and I hope you are back as well. In this position is really important to play with all pieces. So you can see that this queen on g5 is okay. Yes, there is no difficulties how to play with this piece, but how white should play with bishop and rook. You know, it's important and it's the golden rule to play with all your pieces. If you will not play with all your pieces, you will not improve your chess. So, how to make active this bishop? It's difficult to see activity for this bishop if black has this light square pawn formation. So I believe that the first move is e4, because if black will take, you will agree that this bishop on g2 is maybe not superstar, but if this bishop will be on e4, it will be monster, because this bishop will attack g6, will attack c6, and that's a great start for this position. So improve this bishop, and the difference between bishop on g2 and bishop on e4 is so huge that you should have a right feeling for the activity, for improving your pieces. This is really the most important topic if you really wish to improve your chess. So took on e4, and now find the best plan, find the best move for white. And you know, we have to do something with this rook. Where we wish to see this rook, just show one square, show something where you wish to see the rook. Of course, don't show me a3, a2, a1, don't show me d3, e3, because rook belong to the open file. we have only two open files, and you can see that there's F and H open file. If we are going to F file, probably this will be only exchange, so not big different. But if we are going to H file, that's making sense because there has a black weakness. You can see that weakness is H6, H7, and of course this piece looks like to be weak if we are on the right file. So beautiful move to C2, and of course a really strong plan to go to H2, but at least you can see that white is playing with all his pieces. He don't want to play with only two pieces, he's playing with all pieces, and this is the right time to show you that in this game Bland went to F7 and he has threat to go to F1, and of course we have our plan to go to H2, but we have to be careful. We have to ask why black played to F7, and of course it's not difficult answer that black wish to go to F1. For this reason, don't hurry. Every time check your opponent's threats and take care about his threats, because then you are able to find a nice move, bishop to d3, and you can see even this piece is on f file. It's difficult to go there, it's difficult to hurt ourselves, and that's the most important, to be careful, to watch our opponent threats, and if there's no threats, just go for your plan. And you can see that this plan is really great. Another example where white is playing with all his pieces, where white is playing somewhere where black is weak, because you can see that everything this where I'm was red is weak, and that's now difficult position for black. It's great game, and I hope now you are able to spot winning moves or winning plan for white, and the winning plan is to go to f6, because this endgame is lost. Sometimes it will help you endgame. Sometimes check if there is no options to go to a really interesting endgame. And this is another signal that you are improving chess player. You should find help in middle game with activity, with the right plan. But sometimes you should find help with to go to a really great endgame. And that's happened here. Take. Of course, it's not a good idea to take, because we will take the rook. So g8. And we have more material, and you can see that the bishop on e4 is our winning piece, and after d5 that's game over, because this bishop will go to b7 and take, and white is winning. What's happened here? In this position it's difficult to see that this bishop will be a really winning piece, but it's great to see this example. It's great to have the right feeling that we have to play with all pieces. So the plan was to go to e4, this rook should go to c2 and h2, and this piece is waiting here. Beautiful example how to improve our chess. You know, it's not necessary to study 100 books, it's not necessary to study thousand diagrams. It's really important to watch great games of great players, and I hope this example is worth to see, and I hope you don't mind. I'm going to another example. White move. What do you think? What's the best plan for white in this position? And once again, maybe stop this video for a few seconds, few minutes, and come back, and of course ask yourself where black is weak. If black has this g5 or g7, maybe he's not so weak as he is weak in this position. And what's the biggest weakness for black is this open diagonal. You know, this is the biggest weakness, and what white wish to build is to go somewhere to b1 and then to go to c2. So to b1 and to c2, I will try to my try to make marks. So something like this. If you will build, the biggest threat is checkmate on h7, and it's difficult for black to to be okay with this position, because once again, the different is the weakness, and the different is the plan. It's in this position you can play really maybe 100 moves, but the best moves are built with your plan. So the first plan is go to b1, and you wish to go here. You wish to attack black, where is weak and is weak on h7, but you have to find the best squares for all your army. So what do you think you will do with this knight? And yes, great, you should attack. Every time if you are going to attack something, that means your opponent has to defend something, and that means you are attacking chess player and your opponent is defender. So just attack your black's queen on f6 and now improve another piece. Yes, of course, you have the threat to go to c2, but don't be hurried. Just improve this rook. Where do you think this rook will be good rook? And maybe this rook should go to e5, because maybe you will take on g5. This bishop should go to g3, and at the end maybe you will go to c2. So you can see that once again white has plan for all his pieces, and that's great. That's great signal that you understand chess, if you understand this plan and if you like this position, because you know chess is the same every time. Chess are same 100 years, and you know, just the righteous plan is the plan where we can work with all our pieces. So we are going to improve the rook, and maybe I will show the threat. If for example black is playing to e7, what's the threat? The threat is to take on g5. What do you think? It's a big threat or is a small threat? I will tell you, it's a winning threat. So if you try to improve your calculation, just stop this video and try to find all variation till end. And if you did, black will take, white will take, and of course you are going here and you are winning, because it's checkmate here on g7 or h7. Of course somewhere, sometimes it's a threat to f6. So what's a threat if you are going to e5? For this reason, black played f5, but you know, black is losing material and that's nearly game over, and we should go faster and faster. But what's more, you can see that this light squares is weak, is weakened, and is a weakness. And you know, you are building plan around these weaknesses, and you know, I believe that experience is the best way how to improve our chess. Now we should go d5, d6, d7, d8. If this plan will work, we are winning. If this plan will work not very well, we should attack this h8 piece. So d5, now we are going to attack h4. We are going improving, and it looks like a really a good game. Of course, now we are only 2 moves from victory. We are only 1 move from victory, and we are winning, because the biggest weakness was still this piece, and the biggest problem was from beginning at the pawn formation h6 g5. And you can see we are coming back. It's a difficult maybe to see that the biggest reason to lose for black is this pawn formation. This is a really weakness, and you can see that at the end is the reason why black lost. And another reason used to be the right plan for white. He know that he has to play with all his army, so he should see that he will go here, he will go here, maybe he will take on g5, he should improve this bishop to g3, and one day maybe he will go to e2 or c2. And you know, there is so many threats, and this is so good position for black. So black lost, but black lost because of white's good play and white's good plan. And of course, maybe it's difficult to find this plan, maybe it's difficult to understand all these moves, but Once again, I believe to experience. I believe that with experience, we are improving chess player, and this is the best way how to improve our chess. And for this reason, I will show another example. This is example where you are black, and what do you think how to play this position? This position is coming from open Spanish game, and you know it's good to know this endgame by heart. So, what do you think? It's black. Worst or black is winning in this position. And I will tell you that the secret is black is nearly winning. The biggest weakness is, and I will ask you, where do you think is the biggest weakness in this position for white? And the biggest weakness is this e5, because you know it's on dark squares. White has the dark squares bishop. This means this bishop will be bad bishop or should be the bad bishop in the game, and our plan is to go to d5, of course. Now our plan is one day to attack this pawn, and one more important plan, what we don't want to see is move f4 g5, because if this white will play it, white will be in a right position, maybe he will play for win. So very important first plan, how to stop white to play f4. This is a really important position, and you need to remember move g5, because if you are able to play g5 in these positions, you are a really strong chess player, because after g5 you can see that will be difficult for white to go for help for this pawn. It's difficult to play f4 because we have g5 pawn and we have time to go here. If one day black will play g3 or f3 or f4, you can see that then we can go somewhere to c6, d5, one day to e4, f3, g2, and we are winning. So even white will try to improve or to support his weak pawn, he will make another weaknesses. So f3, and of course in every endgame is good to go to center. So yes, we are there. f4, yes, you can see that white played f4, but I hope you agree that white has another weaknesses, and these weaknesses are really so big that white is nearly lost. The difference, of course, will be once again if black will have more active his pieces than white, and this is every time. Work the best advice, work with all your army. So take and go to d4. Now we are waiting for this knight. If knight will go somewhere, of course we are going for exchange. If this knight will not go anywhere, or the knight will be a really bad knight without plan, and at the end if this knight will move, we are going forward and we are winning. Just watch these weaknesses. Looks like they are not so weak, but they are weak. This is the bad bishop, this is a really bad knight, bad piece, and the difference between activity and not activity will be every move bigger and bigger. So yes, knight to f1, well done, that's move what we are waiting for. We are going to e4. Now we should improve this knight, so just go to f5, and you can see that the big threat is maybe to lose this bishop, because if we will take this bishop, we will take one pawn, another pawn, and that's the weaknesses. Is a really great great plan to attack weaknesses, improve everything. Okay, we can take this knight without any hard thinking, and now we can see the difference between the king and black is winning, because you know it's difficult to see that this piece white will not be a winning piece. So okay, we can go faster, it's not so difficult, just go take, and now a winning move h3, and black wish to go here. For this reason, we are going e5, and it's difficult to stop us to play h2, h1. If now white will go to g1, of course we are winning with our biggest hero. So I believe you enjoy this game, and we are going to another position. So in this position, it's difficult maybe to see the right plan, but it's not so hard. This position, white is weak on c4, b3, b2, and one of the defender or the best defender of all the squares is this knight. So because another threat is f4, it's very difficult to find a job for this bishop. I believe that the best plan is to take on d2 and then to attack these weaknesses. So every time start your plan with thinking where your opponent is weak, and maybe you can try to find a defender. You can think if you can shoot this defender and just go for your plan. So maybe one day this rook will go to a5, and to c5 you will attack this c4 weakness. Another plan will be to go to a5 and maybe b3, because with knight on b3 you are nearly winning, because this knight will be so strong and so dangerous for white, so it will be difficult position for white. So we have the plan and we are going to watch this game. So black took on d2, went to a5, exactly as the plan we have. Now we are going to a5 and to c5, and you can see that, you know, great, the plan is working. We made a plan for knight, rook, and everything is standing well, so we are ready to go for winning moves. And now white played to d3. It's difficult to save this weakness, because it's not option to go to d3, because we are going to a5 and we will take it. So this weakness is lost, and at the end the game is lost. So we are going faster. You can see that the activity of black is bigger and bigger. He has more pawns, and one day he will play c4, c3, c2, c1, or b4, b3, b2, b1, or a3, a2, a1. So there's a more pawns on the wing, bigger activity, more space, and once again is winning. So d3, c4, and I'm going faster because I wish to show some more examples, and this game is not so interesting. So of course white resign. Everything started somewhere here, where we know where white is weak, we know where white has weaknesses, and a really important plan, attack your opponent weaknesses. To be a really improving chess player, you need to spot opponent weaknesses and attack his weaknesses, and that's the best plan, that's the advice, and you will have a really fast improving if you are able to spot weakness and attack weakness. And what's more, the best trainer is chess games with chess masters. This game is not so hard, but it's difficult to see how to play, how to set up your army. So what do you think where black is weak? And I will tell you that black is weak, of course, somewhere here. Once again, you can see that here there is no army. Even here there is only one knight, and that's nothing. So even it looks like white will play g4, h4, but not with this piece on g1. So we wish to go one day to b4 and open another wing. And so how we are going to play this game? We are going to f2. With f2 piece we are so strong on f-file, so black has to take some time to be fine with open f-file and need to be defender of f-file. But our main goal is not to be lord of f-file, but our main plan is then improve this knight. How, or what do you think how white will improve this knight? And I believe that you can see that move to c3, of course the threat is to go to d5, but another threat is to go to a4, and we will to attack probably the biggest weakness on black's territory is a c5 pawn. And at the end, we are playing b4, and we are so fast to go to a1 and attack this piece. Maybe it's look difficult, but it's not so difficult, but it's of course every time important to know, to have experience with this position. So I hope that you will enjoy this position. The first move, we know it, why white played to f2, he's attacking on c5, he wished to see another weakness, so he wished to see one more whole moves where black has another weaknesses, and now it's time to improve this knight. This knight should go here, and he's waiting for chance to go to d5, or he's waiting for chance to go here. So you can see step by step white has plan, but it's difficult to see what's the black's plan. After b4, it's difficult to take on b4 because black will be lost on b6, and you can feel, you should have feeling that, you know, black is under big attack. The reason is that here there is no defender, there is no friends, there is nobody who can help blacks to survive this position. And after g4, of course, we are going to close position, and we are going to take on b6, and that's game over, because there is so many weaknesses that check and black resign. What's a game that was so nice, so beautiful, so amazing, so nice to have this plan. When I saw first time this position, for me it was really hard to see what's the plan, how to play this position. I was not sure how to play, but now I know that these positions are bad for black, and I should find these moves and this attack, and I believe that that's the best way how to improve. I wish to improve, I hope you wish to improve, and at the end these games should help you. I hope you are enjoying this video. And where we are in another position, it's a vital move, and this is not so difficult, so I hope you are able to find these winning moves in 5 seconds. So 1, 2, 3, 5, and the biggest weakness is of course f5. If you are able to play over these weaknesses, you are winning. So how to ship this knight to f5? I thought that I will go to e2, to e4, then knight to h4, and knight to f5. Yes, that's not bad, but you know, Max Euwe used to be world chess champion, and he has the same plan, but he's starting with move g4. Oh, great move, of course. After g4, black has no chance to take, because he will lose a g4 piece. So there's so fast to go there, because black has only one move. Of course, he will not go to g5, need to go to g6, but everything is with attack and with tempo. So we are going to h4, once more shot, and we are there. This knight is winning piece, and that's the biggest difference between this knight and bishop, because we know where black has weaknesses, where black is weak, and you know, just go for weaknesses, find a plan, and you are winning. And check on, oh, that's not so difficult to win this game. So we are going faster, and I love this example, because this example was not so difficult, and you know, I believe that this example will help you to improve your chess. So once again, where black is weak, is weak on f5, so just go for that, take your time, take your chance, and you know, you are a winning chess player. And we are going to another example. Where we are? Yes, and this example is difficult, so it's maybe the hardest example of this video. In this example, you can see that the black is weak here, is this, and squares are really the biggest weakness, and just to win these weaknesses, we have to play with this bishop, and this bishop love open files. So everything makes sense if you will play move f4, because you are going to open this important diagonal, you are going to attack black weaknesses, and at the end it's not so hard. So just we went here, take, so of course we are not winning over these weaknesses, but we have another chance. What's this weakness? This is a big problem of black, and where black has another problem. Yes, this knight is absolutely out of game, so now black has three weaknesses. Bad knight, he has bad e5 pawn, he has very weak squares over close to his king, and what's more, black has no active pieces. So four weaknesses and one more space. Another idea. White has more space. So five weaknesses, five advantages for white. So there's a winning position. Okay, one exchange. Why not? And if black is playing here, we are playing to f3 because another weakness is f7. So this game is lost. And the biggest difference is this knight. This knight is doing nothing on e7, and this is really my advice. Play with all your pieces. Don't play with knight on a7. Don't have this knight on a7 because there's a 100 years chess rule that if one piece is bad, everything's bad. And you can understand that this position is exactly bad for black because knight on a7 is bad. So we don't want to exchange because now we wish we will win this game over here. You can see that it's beautiful. If we have so bigger chance to attack so many weaknesses, we should choose if we will attack e5, we should choose if we will attack on f5 or dark squares. That is so nice game, so h4 and the game is won after when this is going somewhere here and here, and at the end we are winning exactly where we started this position. Before that, we are going to win over this open file. So we are there, and one more check, and black resign. We started this game somewhere here where we wish to win, somewhere where black has weaknesses. Black has weaknesses on dark squares. And the last move is here. Black lost because he is weak on dark square, and that's the plan, that's the best way how to improve. I hope you enjoy this position, because what's a game, what's experience, what's a, I don't know, everything nice, beautiful chess. So I love it, and where we are, and we have one more example. What do you think, what's the biggest black weakness? And I will tell you, or I will not tell you, I will give you 1 minute, so maybe think a minute and then come back, because this is a really beautiful one. And the biggest weakness, I hope you did, and I hope you spent 1 minute, because I don't want to wait here so long. So biggest weakness is on d6, and this is a really great example once again how to improve your chess, how to go there, how to take this weakness. Of course, not so difficult to play e5, then go with this knight to e4 and go to d6, and knight from d6 will attack f7, attack to b7. I hope we can go to f3, maybe we should go to fh, and maybe we should attack everything here. Once again, after move e5, just check that once again here there is no defender. Something wrong is here for black, and you know, we have the plan because we know it. We saw so many examples here, and these examples are not far from each other. So, you know, it's making sense to watch this game. And to f2, maybe we are going to h4. So, yes, now we are going to d6. Great. We are there. We are attacking f7. We should attack one, twice. Four times to attack f7, so yes, exactly, we are going to d3, and even here we see that another weakness, and the same weakness as I showed today, and I believe you will remember for rest of your life. Just there is no pieces, there is no defenders, there is our chance. So h3, and we are winning here, because of course black will not take on f7 because of a rook on h8, And you know, when we have more material, there is not so big difficulties. We will take everything. Yes, this game. Okay, what more? We took on f4 and just watch this beautiful game where white took on d8, he took on e6, and now he went to b3. And you know, this is a great example. It's difficult for black to save his piece. And if black will go, for example, to h6, he has so big disadvantage with material. So he has to take on e2, but at the end, it's of course lost endgame. And this endgame is won for white. So maybe we can watch this game, because this is, I believe, the last game of this video. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you got new informations how to improve your chess. I believe you will remember that the best plan is where our opponent is weak. And I hope it will help you, some of these examples, to improve your chess. Thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you very much for subscribing our YouTube chess channel. And thank you very much that you are with us. I believe that we should be one big chess family. We should improve our chess. We should have fun with chess. And that's everything what I wish. So at the end of the video, thank you very much for watching. And I hope I will see you soon.